The question I'm often asked by people is, so what happens between flights? My favorite thing about working on the XB-1 program is that you get to see the full life cycle, everything from concept to reality. I work with all the system owners to design, test, and analyze the performance of each system. This work started long before we took to the air. It began with a series of hangar tests, ground tests, and then taxi tests. In each of these stages, after each of these events, you are evaluating if the system works as intended or if different tweaks and adjustments need to be made in order to be successful when we fly. This requires significant data processing and comparison to analytical models of performance. Once we're happy with the ground performance, we're ready to go fly. XB-1's flight test campaign is about perfecting the aircraft through a series of flights. No matter how well everything works on the ground, you're going to be learning new things as we expand the envelope during flight. The engineering finally becomes real once we get data from a flight. For example, we finally entered a part of the envelope where our automated stick force modulation started working, and the pilot got different force feedback than he had felt before. So prior to that flight, we spent a lot of time reviewing how that system works and what to expect. Another example is the first time that we extended and retracted the XB-1 landing gear during flight. We did a ton of hangar testing ahead of time, but on an experimental program like this, it's typically not feasible to actually simulate the aerodynamic forces the gear will see in flight. We mitigate this by putting a ton of margin into our design, but it's still a huge relief and a big success when the gear works successfully for the first time in flight. And then we get to do a data review and compare our predictions to the actual data that we got from the flight. Now that we have a few flights under our belt, the team is getting used to the test, analyze, review cycle that allows us to clear the envelope for each subsequent flight as XB-1 makes its way to Mach 1. I'm Erin Young, and I'm the XB-1 Senior Manager of Aircraft Systems for Boom Supersonic.